said your burger. I ain't got a fling for a town girl. Downtown girl said let's get it, girl. I ain't got a fling for a ting. I got a ting that make you sing. Well, yeah, I ain't got a fling for an uptown girl. Downtown girl said free town girl. I ain't got a fling for a Cairo girl. Nairobi girl said Kigali girl. I ain't got a fling for an uptown girl. Downtown girl said free town girl. I ain't got a fling for a ting. I got a thing that'll make her sing. More things than a man them could ask for. More things than the stamps in my passport. I didn't move it like Okada, how I'm ripping. I've been begging for a break. Why you wanna hit the gas for? I got a fling for a ting. Am I gonna pay? She love me since I make me do it. I'm a red. But like today, I get your love. Come on, come on, babe. I disappear from my bitch. I know I'm on the way. Now I go take you from the cake to the Benzo.
Solo eres tú. Sabes que solo eres tú. Solo eres tú. in a your fine face, me I want to see every morning when I wake up. You dey intoxicate me every day, honey. I love the way our body move when we make love, make love.
I'm a love boy, I'm a love boy. Bless me heart to the bum, to bum bum, soft to the bum bum. You didn't make me happy, you know, no. I'm a love bum, I'm a love bum. Say you bless me heart to the bum, to the bum bum, soft to the bum bum. You didn't make me happy, you know, no. I'm a love bum.
Got me longing for your body. I'ma get you, you go ride me like limousine. Look at you, as I break your back, you sing it, daddy, yo. Singing in my limo. Kalina, your fine face, me I want to see every morning when I wake up. You dey intoxicate me every day, honey. I love the way our body move when we make love, make love.
I'm a love bow, I'm a love bow. Can you bless me your heart to get up on? To your bum bum, soft to your bum bum. You can make me a heart to get up on. I'm a love bow, I'm a love bow. Can you bless me your heart to get up on? To your bum bum, soft to your bum bum. You can make me a heart to get up on.
Afternoon. We are almost there. We will begin the ceremony in about 10 minutes. To all the family members out there, friends, alumni, and distinguished guests, I welcome you to the International School of Tanganyika's graduation ceremony for the class of 2023. Before we begin, I just want to make a few announcements. I want to remind you that we do have photographers who will be taking pictures throughout the ceremony. We ask that you remain in your seats so that they can take photographs and so that you do not block the view of others. Digital photographs will be shared with you a few days after today's ceremony, and there will be an opportunity for you to purchase printed photos. Also, please be reminded to turn your mobile phones off or keep them on silent during the ceremony. For those of you who are attending the post-ceremony dinner, if you walk through the back of the tent and up the stairs toward the pool area, that is where the dinner will commence after the ceremony. So at this point, I invite you to come have a seat, find your seats, and we'll begin in about 10 minutes.
Let it be, let it be.
they give me what I really, and I feel leave your side. Many killer got me for my. Give me sign, make a come inside. Show them for me, say they hear me so, hear me so. Day and night, now you day my mind. See you want me, can die, no.
Why don't you listen when I talk? I don't like the way you drive off. You don't have to curse, I'll back off. I'm not recognizing my girlfriend. I was still thinking this shit was all rosy. Now it's so cold in these streets, I'm so lonely. Out here fucking with chicks that don't know me. Babes, we know they're close to your level, no story. Now I'm having cold nights and low vibing. It's too lifeless for my own liking. I don't write things where I want that I speak. I don't type since, I still wipe it. I'm trying to tell you that I got fucked up. Please don't throw that back, it costs way too much. See, yourself no say I no feet to cook. I don't go feet deny, it's been way too
tough. You want me to die, die, no.
Fucking baller, I don't need me. No man fi talk shit to me, me loony. You go collect you.
See, I'm on a me daily, that she want you. I'm a fucking baller, I don't need me. No man fi talk shit to me, he look me, you go collect you. Chasing my friends and click. When I call them, I all pulling up. We strapped up with the guns and the swords and things. Bring help to anybody who try to test me. I'm your dad, I'm your uncle, I'm your popsy. I be old man, no go, they call me Gen Z. Where I see, steady giving them up. Multi love far, they can never near me. I smile of a lover, just go. My own, you know I don't show. I'm on my polo white, my face show. Sweet boy for life, you don't know. But serious, baby, worry my phone. And this up for back, you don't know. Every day we dey run a monk call. Supposed to know how the thing go. Man get united till I fade out. If the vibe no pure, my way out. Pull a ball, anytime we step out. The men them outside, we know their house. No they look for us, we know their house. Though they see the mula, we don't spray out. Thank God, say the maga don't pay out. Okay, see, I'm ahead of them as she want you. I'm a fucking baller, you don't need me. No man fi talk shit to me, he look me, you go collect you. See, I'm on a media leader, she want you. I'm a fucking baller, you don't need me. No man fi talk shit to me, he look me, you go collect you. I'm on a different stage. Singlet belt and ripped up jeans. Man to eyes, I know if you lose that cheese. Olu what under my body with blessings. When you leave that team, when I say kukuru cook that team. Who they check, who they check, I'm all you look that team. Face white, yash black, I rebuke that team.
Family members, friends, alums, distinguished guests, the time has arrived. I would kindly ask that after the processionals that you remain seated, remain standing for the Tanzanian National Anthem. And at this point, please stand as we welcome in the IST teaching faculty. Moment we've all been waiting for. Please welcome the class of 2023. Thank you. please remain standing for the Tanzanian national anthem.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. I would like to extend a very warm welcome to parents, relatives, invited guests, faculty and staff, members of the IST Board, the IST Alumni Association, and our soon-to-be IST graduates. Welcome to our ceremony to honor the achievements of the class of 2023. My name is Mark Hardiman, and it is my honor to be the director at the International School of Tanganyika. Thank you. As we begin tonight's ceremony, I would like to start by offering thanks to our parents, relatives, and guests in the audience today for raising great kids and for trusting IST with the honor of working with these amazing young people. We are extremely appreciative of your support, engagement, and commitment to this fantastic group of students. Great schools rely on strong partnerships, and it has been a pleasure working collaboratively with you to provide these students with opportunities to be challenged, supported, and inspired. I would also like to thank the faculty and staff members at IST who have all contributed to the journey that these students have undertaken. Thank you for the commitment you have made to the growth and development of each of your students. This has truly been a team effort, and seeing these amazing young people before us make all of these efforts worthwhile. And to our graduating class, ceremonies like these are one of the few occasions in our lives where we come together to celebrate the passage from one significant stage in life to another. As we reflect on your past experiences, I hope that you all feel a tremendous amount of satisfaction and pride. We are all here to honor your individual journeys that have led to this moment. Ultimately, today is a day to celebrate the culmination of your shared experiences, a recognition of years of planning, effort, joys, hardships, successes, and failures which have exemplified your school experience. It is fitting that we are holding this ceremony as the sun sets on the horizon, looking upon the beauty of the Indian Ocean. This is an apt metaphor for our time together here tonight. As Richard Evans once remarked, sunsets, like childhood, are viewed with wonder not just because they are beautiful, but because they are fleeting. It is my belief that as we grow older, we begin to recognize the power of these fleeting moments. I know that you have spent much of your time in high school focused on the future, preparing for exams, college applications, plans for your gap year, and it is natural to yearn for the future and the tremendous opportunities that await you in the coming years. I also know that periods of transition such as this will bring back a flood of memories, many of which we will celebrate with you tonight. You have climbed to the peak of Kilimanjaro, worked with school children in rural Tanzania, started NGOs to support the less fortunate, won ICEA titles, and provided educational opportunities to others in our local community. You have represented IST in tremendously powerful ways, and we are truly appreciative of your willingness to share your vast talents and experiences with each other and the school community. And that is why I would urge you to take advantage of tonight's fleeting moment as you would a beautiful sunset. Take advantage of this opportunity to be present with your friends, family, teachers, and loved ones. Take advantage by being ready to be celebrated and to celebrate with everyone in this space who has committed themselves to supporting your growth and your development. Tonight is our chance to share a valuable moment with you and to recognize and acknowledge the special place that the class of 2023 will always hold in the history of IST. As you all know, we recognize transitions at IST with the understanding that once a Twiga, always a Twiga. I believe that we are the only school in the world that has the Twiga as our mascot. This makes us extremely unique, but I am also confident that our mascot is an apt one for the students that we serve and the soon-to-be graduates that are being celebrated here tonight. Twigas symbolize personal and collective strength, a commitment to take action, and the will to have a positive impact on one's life and the lives of others. I cannot think of a better way to describe the attributes of the class of 2023, and I'm confident that each of you is ready to leave your mark on a world that is desperately in need of more Twigas. Thank you, and congratulations to our graduating Twigas, the International School of Tanganyika class of 2023.
Members of the class of 2023, parents, esteemed faculty members, IST board members, family and friends. We are here to celebrate these 57 candidates for graduation who will soon become alumni of the International School of Tanganyika. They've met the school requirement for graduation, and many of them are also leaving with essential culinary skills after taking Miss Reber's gourmet ramen noodles class and learned the survival skill of changing a car tire in my session. To begin, seniors, I ask that you stand up and face the audience to participate in this exercise. When I call out the years that you joined the school, please sit down. All those of you who joined IST within the last 2 years, please sit down. If you joined the school in grades 9 or 10, please sit down. It's interesting to note that 36 students are sitting down. Over half of the graduating class entered IST at some point in their high school studies. If you joined the school in grades 7 or 8, please sit down. If you joined the school in grades 5 or 6. If you joined the school in grade 3 or 4. If you joined the school in grades 1 or 2. Those students who entered in early childhood are standing before you. They only know IST and are 100% Twigas. We wish them all the best as they make their first We wish them all the best as they make their first transition to a new school. Please sit down. While we are talking numbers, the members of the class represent 20 different nationalities. And this trivia question, how many members of the class are children of IST teachers? 7 is actually the correct answer. And 4 of them live in the same building in Twiga Apartments. Reflecting back, this class started high school in August 2019, and their freshman and sophomore years were interrupted by COVID-19. They were subjected to online, remote, synchronous, asynchronous, and hybrid learning. There are some familiar words includes social distancing, virtual assemblies and events, masks, isolation, quarantine, temperature checks, contact tracing, Zoom bombing, and the all too familiar statement, you're muted. We all cringe when we think back to those days, and many of us still have nightmares. Experts have no idea what the long-term impact of the pandemic will be on this generation. We hear a great deal about a greater number of young people who are managing mental health challenges and that students have gaps in their learning. There's no doubt that these have been challenging times, but this group of young adults provides us with hope for the future. We see examples of them building community through meaningful relationships. They've shown resilience and perseverance in overcoming adversity. And there are signs that some of them are rethinking their priorities and changing their future plans. Members of the faculty talk about how much this group has bonded in the last 2 years. They started out as a collection of individuals and over time created their own group identity. There are many examples of how they supported each other in good times and bad. It's rare for this to happen with groups this large and diverse. Maybe, just maybe, the pandemic experience has taught them the value of close relationships and showing compassion for others, which may have led this group to becoming more united. Faculty members also say there's less drama than they've seen with other classes in the past. Graduates, is this true? There are also talented and dedicated competitors in this group who've contributed to 8 ICEA championships. 13 members of this class are ICEA champions, and 8 of the girls have won multiple titles. One of the ICEA champions even founded the ICEA chess tournament, which IST won this year. Robbed of these competitions in grades 9 and 10, they seem to have savored these opportunities to compete with their coaches and teammates. This speaks to their resilience and perseverance, as well as their desire to work together to accomplish goals. They've shown dedication and resilience when it comes to their academic studies. It's possible that the pandemic helped them gain a greater appreciation for learning. One thing is clear, the pandemic has not kept them from succeeding in gaining acceptances into their selected universities. In true IST fashion, a collection of them have been accepted to top universities around the world. To name a few, King's College London, London School of Economics, Barnard College, Carnegie Mellon University, University of Virginia, Queen's University, University of Toronto, McGill University, University Groningen, and Tufts. And finally, maybe the pandemic forced them to rethink their priorities and reconsider their pathways to university. All of the graduates are prepared for and planning to attend university, and they will eventually settle in the UK, the US, Canada, the Netherlands, and other countries around the world. Currently, 18 of them are planning on taking a gap year next year. This doesn't mean they won't go on to university. It just means that it won't be next year. After 4 difficult years, they may be looking for a break, an adventure, or the opportunity to do something new and different. These young adults have developed a broader view of what is possible after high school. We can learn from them as they demonstrate the courage to take a path less traveled. Let's face it, there's probably many adults in this room who are thinking that a gap year would feel pretty good right now. Soon-to-be graduates, we have faith that each and every one of you will take a path that's best for you, and you'll have many opportunities to fulfill your potential and improve the world. And we all know that our world needs quite a bit of improvement these days. You provide us, with all of us, with the hope for a better future. Congratulations.
As you all probably know already, Tibelo Koboko, known to some as TB, is really cool. She did tell me to say that, but the good news is that it's true. I first realized how cool Tibelo was when I was her personal project supervisor back in grade 10. She submitted a video of her final product with a song by Drake playing in the background. And I appreciated both her originality and her taste in music. Then in grade 11, I again got to experience her greatness when I was her DP math teacher. I learned very quickly that she had a natural gift for being able to make people laugh. Somehow she was able to make binomial expansion entertaining and would refer to, you know, that dude Pascal, who was, when she was explaining how to find the binomial coefficient. This year, Tibelo has been an amazing leader among an amazing leader amongst the cohort, emceeing events and always maintaining the positive vibes. She has a heart of gold. No other senior loves my one-year-old, Theo, as much as she does. And don't worry, Tibelo, you'll get another cuddle before you head out. It is my privilege to welcome our first student speaker from the class of 2023. The talented, kind, and courageous Tibelo Koboko.
I see it. All right. There's a lot of wind here, so I don't know, man. Good evening, ladies, gentlemen, and soon-to-be graduates. My name is Tibelo, and you probably already know me now because Ms. Kobe introduced me, And I guess for those who don't know me, I'm graduating today. Thank you, thank you. IB has been a journey, a painful one, but also a memorable one. But before anything, I'd like to thank me first for putting me first and helping me get through this very hard system. Self-love, self-love. Anyways, I'd like to thank me for helping me get through this very hard system given what I've gone through as an individual. So I was gonna ask you for a round of applause, but you've done that already. As I was saying, the IB has been a painful but memorable journey. And to be honest, I think my IB year started in grade 10. I truly started to see that life's not a joke. I started to learn this when Lujane decided to wake up and gather the confidence to wear slides without socks and come to class. She came up with so many excuses, and I remember her suggesting that she needs freedom. But in the true and inspirational words of Rosa Parks, Anushka and I responded with, nah. All in all, I'd like to give a shout out to my little family, my sisters, my group of six. They've been there for me, and I couldn't ask for better loving friends. I'd also like to give a shout out to all the moms I've met during these years who fed me amazing food and sheltered me. Shout out to Elisa's family. And I'm also here to make a statement that biology is better than ESS. And I just know the ESS class is about to sit me down after this, and I'm not scared. Now, I see you, Nadia. I see you. Now, the great group chat. Yeah, that's right. I will never forget how there will be a whole serious conversation going on, and you have very specific people. Jeff, Arav, Tumaini. Very specific people sending random GIFs and weird videos just for the fun of it. Then we have the people who miss the whole conversation and the whole point of it, Shiko. And others waking up in the morning to more than 200 messages coming to school saying, ah, guys, I couldn't bother. Can you update me? Or people just walking around clueless with no idea what even happened, Lujane. But you guys, I think that we might be the most unbothered IB2 grade in IST so far in history. I've attended IST for almost 7 years now, and every IB2 grade that came before my eyes was always so like fashionable. And I remember 1 year there was a girl who decided to cut her hair. She went bald and she looked so good, like she owned her looks. But this year, wow. Yeah, wow. You'd arrive in school on a normal day and you find DB just sleeping on a random table. And at lunch, we have hustlers begging the canteen guy for free food, free sugar, a spoon. You go to the library and you find 4 or 5 people still in their pajamas and you ask yourself, what's going on? You look to your left and you find a whole chiropractor zone where Elisa is just cracking people's backs and asking them to breathe in and out for her to just say, ah, you're not breathing out well, do it again. Some people just never showed up, and if they did, it was like, wow, you really showed up, that's so good for you. But if there is one thing this IB 2 years got, is teamwork and a sense of togetherness. We're like a family. Even if we don't see eye to eye sometimes, we still find a way to have fun together and respect each other as well. There have been things that we've gone through as a grade, or things that a person in the grade has gone through, and somehow it's brought us all together to resonate and empathize with them. I just know that what is amazing about us is that we don't watch people struggle. If someone is struggling, we struggle with them. If someone is happy, then we're happy with them. We also help each other a lot academically and pick each other up when some of us are giving up. We really know each other. We're all friends with each other. And we're all nice to each other no matter what the situation is. If something happened to me now, I know I'll be able to text a group chat, and I know someone was out there who can help me. But it's the fact that I'm able to text a group chat. It's the fact that we're all comfortable with each other to a level where we can reach out for help. And that is something that not many individuals have, and it is the attitude that we should carry with us in our future endeavors, and a sense of unity. Or shall I add in equity, Mr. Fitz, whatever you are. I know you're proud of me. The IB is not easy, and I've seen some soldiers fall off during this battle. I've seen very many people cry over these years, including me, because of the pressure. I've seen people come up with so much worry over an essay they're writing, or a test they just did, or because of personal issues they just have to deal with. But this is what I have to say. We're here, aren't we? All of our battles, the ones that are displayed or the ones that are kept silent, they're all over. Class of 2023, you're the most resilient individuals because you have picked yourself up and carried on being the most loving, funny, affectionate, super intelligent, and involved people. And I think the IST community can never forget us because of this. As I wrap up this speech, let me give you a motivational quote I heard in grade 9 from the man himself, Savily, during PE class. If you believe it, you can achieve it. Don't stop, never stop, congratulations, and never forget, once a Twiga, always a Twiga. Thank you.
Okay, here we are. Good evening, beautiful ladies and gents. Today, I stand before you to express my heartfelt gratitude to the person who not only expanded my vocabulary, but also taught me how to weave words into magical and occasionally very confusing tales. Yup, I'm talking about the bestest, most amazing English teacher I could have asked for, Mr. Cash. First and foremost, let me assure you that I will not be using bombastic language, so you could all keep your dictionaries in your bags, a place where it's meant to be. But don't worry, I promise to keep it simple and sweet. Now, we all know that English class can sometimes be as challenging as trying to untangle headphone wires. But thanks to Mr. Cash, every moment has been entertaining, yet educational, to the extent that English could arguably be one of my favorite classes. His dedication to our academic success and his determination to see us all succeed is truly commendable. Even his enthusiasm for literature is quite contagious. I mean, who else can make reading tragic tales so entertaining? His love for this language has instilled in us a love for the written word and the power it holds. They've encouraged us to think critically, express ourselves eloquently, and explore the depths of our imagination. And for that, we're forever grateful. So let's raise our pens. I don't have any. But let's raise our pens and give a big round of applause to the amazing Mr. Cash, who has been our beacon of knowledge and humor. Yes, I did just say humor. As Shakespeare said, all that ends well is well. So I just want to end by wishing you a good luck for your journey ahead, and metaphors be with you. Get it? Metaphors? And of course, our good luck, our good old good luck and Godspeed. Let's have another round of applause for Mr. Cash.
DB hates me now. She insisted to me that she was 5'2", so I now have to make fun of her for it. Good evening, graduates, faculty, family, parents, friends, and whoever else decided to rock up to someone else's graduation. Whatever you do on your Saturday night, I don't know. First off, I'd just like to say I've taught almost everyone in this grade at one point, many of you for 2 or 3 years. And as your team leader last year, I spent a lot of my time talking about you, thinking about you, and, well, you know, you were my job for a year. And knowing how hard all of you have worked, I'm honestly speechless on what words would best honor you as a group of people in this format. So instead, can we please have a round of applause for our graduates, please? I've been told I have about 5 minutes or so to speak on behalf of the graduating year, but I'm not entirely sure on what. I mean, they chose me, but they didn't give me like a, you know, a mandate or anything. Also, I do question why you chose me. After all, Mr. Melman suggested to me that we needed a translator because so few of you would understand my New Zealand accent. And subtitles are not available in any live stream. Also, with 57 of you, that really only gives me about 4 seconds per student, so I'm not going to turn this into an elongated acrostic poem where I awkwardly name each of you. Instead, I'm going to do what all good teachers do, which is to force on you my opinion and my advice on how you should live your life when none of you asked for it. And perhaps I'll be one of your last school teachers to do this. Unfortunately, the other people who will continue to give you unsolicited advice for the rest of your life are, of course, your parents. But what I'm going to say is not written for your parents, so if they disagree, well, they're welcome to do so. It's written for you as a group of humans who I care about. And what I'm going to tell you today is not something very clever or world-breaking, something very simple and not more complicated than what you'll find on a fortune cookie or a horoscope. But it's something that, in my view, if you regret it, or if you forget it and ignore it, you might come to regret it. And it's a challenge for all of you, a challenge for all of you to not live the next 5 years of your life on autopilot. All of the events in your life, your upbringing, your schooling, have set a trajectory and a pathway that is currently going this direction. And when you cross this stage today, you're going to go in that direction, blindly. I want you to consider, until your life right now, how much choice you've really had. The sports you play are largely influenced by what was available at IST. The friends you have are just partly decided by the lottery scramble of who happened to be in your year group. Who you are today, your personality, the things you like and hate, small things like your politics and big things like your choice of anime, or if you appreciate your teachers making pop culture references like that in your graduation speech, all of these things are hugely influenced by, one, your parents, two, the friends you met at high school, and three, the community around you. When I was in high school, I loved heavy metal. My tastes have slightly changed since. I absolutely loved it, and that was mostly because everyone around me loved heavy metal. System of a Down and Metallica were gods at my school, and there was only one anime that mattered, and that was Dragon Ball Z, because Goku was G-O-A-T. My desire to fit in with the group made me that person. When I left school, I had very small, narrow horizons on what I imagined that I could actually do. I grew up in a small town, went to a poorly run school. 2/3 of my graduating class didn't actually make it to grade 12. And I knew I was good at art and design, so I left school with scholarships to study art and design and become a graphic designer. And by the second year of my design degree, I was a straight A student. I was among the top of my class. And what did I do with all of those good grades? Well, I dropped out. I dropped out of that university course and I changed my entire life pathway. Because once I started to spend time away from my hometown, I started to realize what I really wanted in life. And now, 15 years after high school, I'm here teaching high school English, and I love my job. The people that have surrounded you have sculpted all of you into who you are right now. Every decision that you've made has been influenced by the people around you. And all of those decisions add up to make you. And if you don't take a step back yourself and look at yourself right now in your life, you might just fall into this autopilot. I want you to stop trying to make decisions to please others or to fit in or because it's the easy choice and instead decide what you really want in this world. And I know your parents might say, now, son and daughter, please go ahead in this direction to become that doctor, lawyer, engineer, high achieving, perfect manifestation of all of their dreams. But I encourage all of you to take a step back and think, well, what's in that direction or in that direction? I honestly think that many of the people in my life who have had quarter or midlife crises have had them because they didn't know what they wanted in life. They were doing what didn't match their values or their vision. We all know what domino pieces are. They're those small little squares that if you lose your papers, if you line them all up in a line, they all knock them and they all fall over, right? Well, you come from an old life right now where so much of your life was being decided for you. And crossing the stage today, your graduation begins a life where you have so many more choices. But if you don't start a conversation today with yourself and start asking who you want to be, the dominoes are always going to fall where they're destined to fall. You will walk across the stage today straight into autopilot and might come to regret it. The other hard truth is that whoever you are now is going to change no matter what you do. I doubt there is a single adult in this room who is the same person they were when they were in high school. Your first years out of school will fundamentally change you in ways you cannot predict. When I was in high school, I was terrified of public speaking and speaking in front of others. And I had very little self-confidence to do this. And yeah, I'm doing it now. Similarly, I left high school believing the only thing I was good at was art and design. And yet now I teach high school essay writing, go figure. In my first semester of university, I received a B for my first essay. And I looked at it and I hated it. And I decided that was never going to happen again. And from that point onwards, I was going to be someone who was good at essay writing. And so from that point on, I got straight A's mostly. And not due out of luck or anything, but because of effort, patience, and a clear direction of where I wanted to go. I had limited myself based on myths I told about who I was. And I'm sure many of you have myths about yourselves that you have developed. If you're bad at sports or maths, you can change that. And you can be good at both of them. Not very musical or artistic, or not very confident in yourself, none of that is fixed and all of that can change. It's only a matter of time and effort. So when you cross the stage today, I want you to consider three things. The first is, do you really want to autopilot those years after high school and follow the path of least resistance? The easy preset path where you let the dominoes fall where they're always going to go. Second, I want you to consider what is truly important to you. What is your vision for yourself, your family, and your career? What is your vision for your community or the wider world? And what do you want to change in this world, however small or humble? That's how you break autopilot. And lastly, third, I want you to remember that whoever you are today is going to change. You can change your old habits, you can change the things about yourself that you're not proud of, and you can become a different person. You are no longer limited by high school. In my view, graduation today is a threshold, a transition between your old life and your new life, a new life when many of the limitations on you are now gone. So when you cross that stage today, remember that you are breaking into a new life, and I hope that you enter that new life of vision and purpose. And above all else, before I forget, please remember to call your mum and dad. Thank you all. I'll miss you all, and please don't stay a stranger graduating class. Thank you.
Amazing musician, so talented. Thank you very much for entertaining us. Oh, don't go off, Logan. Come back, guys. Give them one more round of applause.
Wow, thanks guys, that was amazing. Great job, really enjoyed that. Good evening, and congratulations to the class of 2023. It's my pleasure to present on the behalf of the IST faculty, the ASA Award for Excellence. This award is given by the African International Schools Association to a graduating senior who demonstrates high academic results and whose character exemplifies the association's values. ASA award winners actively promote a positive school community. They are involved in service. They seek to understand African cultures, and they are truly global citizens. This year, the award goes to Isabel Reed. Isabel is a confident and collaborative student who demonstrates mature leadership and a joy in learning. A high-achieving IB diploma student, she's taken advantage of the breadth of courses offered to her in this rigorous program, challenging herself in subjects from visual arts to biology to history. Isabel brings a scholar's open mind to her work. She enjoys investigating complicated questions and considering their multifaceted answers. Isabel has energized our IST community on the volleyball and basketball courts. She led the Twiga women to back-to-back volleyball championships and brought a high level of play to her basketball teams. She's won several ICEA All-Tournament Team Awards. We all remember the excitement of that amazing volleyball tournament last year, the inaugural one in our new athletic center, which electrified Twiga school spirit, but it also inspired many younger athletes to come out and play and contribute to our growing programs. Isabel has led successful teams, but she has also modeled sportspersonship for the next generation of Twigas. Isabel developed an interest in bees and beekeeping while at IST. She began a club dedicated to the environmental importance of bees in Tanzania, which now has over 40 enthusiastic members and maintains 4 beehives on campus. Her excellent extended essay entitled "Beekeeping in Tanzania, An Analysis of Current Implementation and Future Predictions" discussed the environmental and economic implications of beekeeping here in Tanzania. Isabel is truly a global citizen. Her participation in class discussions reflects her values of social justice and shows her awareness of differing worldviews. Her stunning jellyfish artwork evokes the beauty and majesty of the ocean and calls on us to care for it. Her participation beyond the classroom, her leadership in the beekeeping club, and the outreach she does with her surfing community demonstrate her commitment to sustainability at the local level here in Tanzania. She keeps herself well informed of current events and has developed an interest in political science, which she hopes to pursue at university. Isabel sees a connectedness between her academic work, her non-academic endeavors, and the wider world. This integrated worldview is quite exceptional. And she sings in a band. And she's a passionate and highly skilled surfer. She's going to do amazing things next year at the University of Washington in Seattle. Please join me in congratulating Isabel Reed.
Good evening, everyone. It's my sincere pleasure to introduce our second student speaker. In his short time at IST, this young man quickly established himself as an enthusiastic and accomplished scholar and athlete, a leader and a true friend to many. It is no surprise that he was chosen by his classmates to represent them here tonight. After my first few interactions with him, I knew pretty quickly that he was a gem. His insight, intellect, humor, and maturity belied his years, and he was clearly passionate about being an agent for positive change in the world. He is, simply put, a good human being. I think his little sister might even attest to that, a true test if there ever was one. Also, his taste in music is pretty good, too. These qualities have endeared him not only to his classmates, but to his teachers, and also to me, his school counselor. Please welcome Mr. Adrian Klaitz.
Just one moment, please. All right, I think I'm ready. First of all, thank you very much, Mr. Melman, for that fantastic introduction, and also all of the valuable counsel you've offered me over the past couple of years. Habari Zagioni, honorary guests, parents, teachers, faculty, family members of graduates, friends of the graduates, friends of the graduates, young guests, old guests, tall guests, and vertically challenged guests, wise guests, not quite as wise guests. It is a great honor to be with you all today. I know that you all have made an immense contribution to making this day possible for each and every one of us, and for that, we thank you. And to my fellow students, congratulations. I know there have been plenty of times many of us have wondered if this day would ever come, especially over the past month or so, but here we are. We did it. Fellow students, I'm really honored and touched that you have chosen me alongside Tabello to represent our class at this graduation. And I hope a few minutes from now, y'all won't find yourselves deeply regretting that decision. For those of you who don't know, I joined IST much later than almost all of my fellow graduates. I transferred here in the middle of my junior year, and as it turns out, switching classes at a new school in the middle of 11th grade in a new continent isn't as easy as it sounds. To those parents in the audience who have younger children and who might one day be considering moving to a new place in the middle of your kids' IB diploma program on their junior year, I have one piece of advice. Don't do it. Well, let me qualify that. Don't do it unless the school you'll be moving them to is IST. The welcoming, gracious community that you all have fostered made me feel at home almost immediately. I'm not sure who I'd be without Jeff and DB's humor, George, Simon, and Logan always inviting me places, Mr. McMahon's philosophical Spanish classes, Mr. Fitz's air-conditioned econ tangents, and many more. The list of great experiences I've had at IST could easily go on and on. One of the best ways I can convey the spirit of community that this graduating class has had here at IST is by reading some excerpts from our famous grade group chat. This comes after a classmate thanks someone else for a cookie they brought in for the grade. I've never fallen in love, but then I ate that cookie. But as fast as it entered my life, it left. Thank you. During a civilized but spirited debate over whether or not we should extend prom invitations to 10th graders, this was one proposed solution that never quite came to fruition. 10th graders can come to prom under the condition they do a public promposal that will be posted on the promposal Instagram. Each promposal will be rated in the comments section, and grade 12s will come to a final decision as to whether or not the couple can come to prom. With this, we will spread prom spirit as well as elevate grade 12 power and superiority. I'm not quite sure why that didn't go through. As you can tell, our grade takes coordination very seriously. As principled, open-minded, balanced, caring, reflective risk takers, we were able to effectively communicate across cultural barriers to achieve aims of global significance. That's what I wrote for my CAS anyway. So, as you embark on your respective gap year journeys and university journeys, you may be faced with some daunting questions like, what do I do with what I've got? To be perfectly candid, I have quite a few questions myself, and nobody has all the answers, But there are two things that I think about when these types of questions arise. The first, a Kinder Surprise egg. The second, Poet Laureate Kendrick Lamar. Philosopher Slavoj Žižek calls the Kinder Surprise egg a, quote, fascinating commodity. A Kinder Surprise egg, for those who aren't familiar, has a chocolate outside which surrounds a plastic toy. I know I, like a lot of children, would break the chocolate egg as quickly as possible to get the toy. But maybe afterward I would turn my attention to the now disintegrated, messy, dirty remains that were once a chocolate egg. One thing I often remind myself is that you shouldn't live your life the way that children approach a Kinder egg. As we go through life, there's a tendency for us to focus on the end results and not to embrace and enjoy the process or the chocolate egg from which we can derive just as much, if not more, joy. I also say this about the Kinder Surprise toy because oftentimes we limit our goals out of fear under the guise of practicality because the pursuit of our true dreams and true ideals seems too far out of reach. Well, I hate to break it to you, but this world seems to me a pretty absurd place, so those so-called practical goals may not work out according to plan either. You might as well follow your true dreams and ideals. As Žižek says about the Kinder Surprise egg, we should aim at the higher goal, or the toy in the middle of the egg, in order to be able to enjoy the surface. That is the balance we must achieve. One gift we've been given by our education or the fortunate circumstances under which we were born to such successful families is that, whether you realize it or not, we are in a much better position than the vast majority of the population to make a real difference. One thing I urge you to recognize is that with these circumstances, a wall is created between us and the less fortunate. What I would urge you all to do, and what I aspire to do myself, is to break down the walls that divide us from the disempowered. And trust me, I know it's easy to create spaces where we don't see the problems of other people, people less fortunate than ourselves, the Yacht Club and Golden Tulips of the world. But when we break down these barriers, we hear things that we need to hear, and we see things that we need to see, even if we don't want to. Although there are some powerful voices that make significant profits by feeding into both your self-doubts and your overall doubts about the potential for societal change, all of you represent the potential that we all may leave this world a more just and equal place than we entered it. If you don't believe me, I'll finish with a slightly adapted quote from Nobel Poet Laureate Kendrick Lamar. No, they can't control you. No, they can't control us, but we can control each other. We build our own worlds. If you don't leave with nothing else tonight, you will leave knowing that you represent something that's bigger than all of us. This is you, this is me, and we are Twigas. Thank you, Asante Nisana.
It's my pleasure to announce the winner of this year's BK Tanna Award. This award is in honor of the former board chair, BK Tanna. During a time when IST was experiencing growth, Mr. Tanna essentially took up the reins of the board and worked closely with the school's directors. He had a great understanding of the local and expat communities and was instrumental in making IST a better and more developed and respected school. One of the most lasting achievements was the adoption of the IB Diploma Program. The director at the time, Mike Mayberry, created the award to honor Mr. Tanna's contributions to IST over the years. The student who's selected for the BK Tanna Award has the following qualities: high academic achievement, outstanding effort for academic success, participation, enthusiasm, and attitude toward extracurricular activities, positive class participation, exemplary behavior and character, and significant contributions to community and social development. There's a spoiler alert here. I won't be able to make it to the end without the student's identity being named, right? This year's winner is an excellent student who's highly respected by his teachers and peers. He's been involved in a long list of activities. Three of them are prominent groups on campus. This individual has demonstrated maturity beyond years, compassion, humility, a positive attitude, and patience for others. He regularly makes time to help others when they have their own looming deadlines. I want to share several of the many quotes that teachers sent me regarding this individual. Mr. Cash said, in terms of class, he was above average, but I believe he was above the average of his class for one key reason, consistency. He always did the work, he always engaged, and he was always curious, eager to ask questions, respond to debates and issues in text. Ms. Reber said that when he decided to forego leaving IST and starting university at the end of grade 10, he was asked why. He shared that he sees the value of learning through a broad range of experiences and topics. He enjoys thinking critically about more than just business and technology. Once he made the decision to stay, he took full advantage of all the IB has to offer and has helped others along the way. His CV is impressive because he's held leadership positions in school clubs as well as outside organizations. The list includes co-founder of Tulia Media Tanzania, founder of Smart Money Investing and Trading, member of the Young Investors Society, co-founder of Umoja TAT, leader in Model United Nations, team leader for Tech Team at IST, executive leader TEDx Youth at Opanga. Many of you know how outstanding IST's tech team is and the excellent work they've done streaming and recording big events. While many ICEA schools spend thousands of dollars contracting the work of streaming ICEA tournaments to companies, IST happily relies on a group of eager and talented students. Prash took the lead 2 years ago when the tech team restarted after COVID. The team started with basic solutions, software and camera work, and finished with the most professional looking live stream for most recent IST football tournament. Mr. Burke says about Prash, he's displayed leadership skills beyond his years and even handled his own succession planning to ensure the continuity and longevity of the IST tech team. We thank you, Prash, because your successors are here tonight live streaming. This year, Prash served as the executive leader of the TEDx event. With TEDx, he led 20 people who managed the budget, selected and then prepared the speakers, designed media and merchandise, created a stage design, hosted guests, recorded and edited videos to be uploaded to the official TED channel. This is a major undertaking, and the team delivered a professional event. With interesting and well-prepared speakers who will impact our community and people around the world. Instead of focusing on all of Prash's work with TEDx, I want to highlight one aspect of his leadership. Mr. Fitzpatrick said that about Prash, I appreciate the level of intellect and thoughtfulness this student brings to our conversations. He considers the topics from a variety of perspectives, and the constructive manner with which this student speaks challenges me to consider new viewpoints, often leading me to reflect on my way of thinking. As a presenter at this year's TEDx event, I witnessed this firsthand. With each draft of my presentation, Prash was not afraid to speak frankly about my work. In retrospect, I consider him a really important thought partner, which helped me deliver a much improved presentation. And he did this for all of the speakers. It's not easy for a teenager to provide an adult, let alone the school principal, with honest feedback. As the group leader, Prash modeled this for others with each one of the presenters. This year's winner of the BK Tanna Award is Prashrad Magaswaran.
Honorable guests, distinguished faculty members of IST, fellow IST board members, deservingly proud parents and guardians, friends, and most importantly, the graduating class of 2023. A wonderful evening to all of you. It is with great honor and joy that I stand here today on behalf of the IST Alumni Association to congratulate the graduates of 2023 and to celebrate this significant milestone with them. As you, the graduates of 2023, leave this evening with your diplomas in hand, you are officially IST alumni. The word alumni is defined as a group of graduates or former students of a school, college, or university who have either attended or graduated from the institution. My name is Shamima Karmali Balu. I graduated from International School of Tanganyika almost 3 decades ago. I still remember feeling what most graduates are probably feeling today. Excitement, uncertainty, anticipation, gratitude, some fear perhaps, and of course relief. I can assure you, however, as someone who has crossed this path already, that you are all equipped with the tools and abilities to overcome any obstacle that may come your way. An education at IST prepares you not only for the professional world, but also for the challenges in life itself. Remember all the values that you have been taught here: integrity, perseverance, resilience, compassion, together with the knowledge of the arts, sports, and sciences. You are all exemplary, global, international students who are incredibly privileged. Graduates, today marks not just the culmination of your time here at IST, but a cemented lifetime relationship with IST. It will always be a part of you. Alumni and their achievements are a wealth of resources and an inspiration to future graduates of IST. So stay in touch, share your stories, stay engaged so we can celebrate your celebrations. Stay connected, give a little advice or support to the IST students, or just send a simple hello from wherever you are. Remember, once a Twiga, always a Twiga. You are now part of a vast and supportive alumni network that is here to guide, mentor, and celebrate your accomplishments. Reach out to your fellow alumni, seek their wisdom, and build connections that will last a lifetime. Fellow alumni, take this privilege and let it help you make a positive impact on the world around you. Embrace the challenges that lie ahead, knowing that you are prepared to make a difference. You are your own powerhouse. Dream it and make it happen. Congratulations, class of 2023, and a very warm welcome on board IST alumni. Thank you.
Good evening. Dr. Hardiman, Dr. Peterson, and members of the Board of Directors, it is our great privilege and honor to present the 2023 candidates for graduation from the International School of Tanganyika. These students have completed all the requirements for the high school diploma.
Based on satisfactory completion of requirements, the faculty and we recommend that they be granted their diplomas and be declared graduates of the International School of Tanganyika, class of 2023.
Let's give him another round of applause. Lujain Aboud. Lujain has been at IST for 9 years and is excited to continue her studies at the University of Dar es Salaam. She wants to thank her family, friends, and teachers for encouraging and supporting her throughout her IB journey.
Mustafa Adumji. Mustafa would like to thank all of his teachers for their support during his academic journey. He is looking forward to studying in the UK and getting his degree in accounting and management. He hopes for the best for his friends on into the future.
Malek Almanji. Malek has loved being the Arabic translator for the grade. She enjoyed hearing people attempt to pronounce Malek correctly.
Nadia Awad. Nadia enjoyed the IB diploma so much that she's begging Mr. Crook to do it all again. Next year, Nadia will be traveling and gaining experiences during a gap year. Nadia would like to thank her teachers, family, friends, especially Alex.
Zaid Bakrinza. Zaid will be attending Lynn University in the United States and pursuing an international business management degree. He will miss life in Dar, spending time with his friends and family and going on road trips around the country.
Bethan Bangay. Beth lived, laughed, loved her way through the last 2 years. She's not at all ready to start university, but it seems she's been left with no other choice. She'd like to thank her parents for all the late nights they've spent helping her with her IAs, as well as her friends Izzy, Nadia, Ruby, Gigi, and Vilda.
Alisa Bojani. Alisa extends her gratitude to her family and friends for their support in her ambitious future endeavors. Don't ask why she chose medicine, because she won't give you a straight answer.
Maya Brancig. With her sights set on studying psychology, Maya is ready to tackle the complexities of the human mind. She thanks her incredible family and friends for their support throughout this journey.
Hannah Broussard. Hannah is excited to graduate. She will always remember the random lunchtime conversations and off-topic class discussions.
Chico Constantini. Chico has never been more excited, but she is also completely clueless about what comes next. She hopes that in the near future, the only parts of this she remembers are the laughs and arguments at the lunch table, the friends that comfort her every time she cried in math, and the people that made this experience a little more bearable.
Hannah Crook. Hannah has made unforgettable memories these past 4 years at IST. She will miss all the people who made this last year amazing. Hannah wants to thank her parents, friends, cats, and the Yacht Club Sunsets for helping her through these exciting and stressful 2 years. Peace, HC.
Ruby Crow Zervis. Ruby loves dogs and is excited to meet many more of them in the UK, where she is planning to attend university to study environmental management. She would like to thank her dogs, Jamie, Eileen, Rebecca, and Picasso, for helping her through the trials and tribulations of school.
Eliza Dietzold. Amidst the cheers and applause, Eliza walks across the stage with a sense of accomplishment and pride. Her dedication and hard work, coupled with the support of her loved ones and invaluable tools such as ChatGPT and Google Translate, have brought her to this moment.
Lily Duguid. Lily had an amazing journey with her final year of IB. She is grateful for her friends, those who've supported her, and is looking forward to a future of road trips, solving mysteries, and finding an apartment next to a Dairy Queen.
Jacob Plossy. Jake is a sentient human being who is looking forward to getting surgery this summer.
Haley Fossgreen. Oh, sorry. Haley Fossgreen. Haley struggled through school but has come out a better person than she went in. She will be remembered by her friends for how she came into school with so much energy at 7:40 in the morning.
Logan Fitchpowell. Logan graduated a year late and wishes to swim with the fishies. He made some fire butter chicken and hopes to become a doctor in the future.
Isabel Gordon Gibson. Isabel, Gigi, and all the other nicknames she has been given the past few years, is excited to start a new chapter in her life whilst carrying all of the amazing memories that she has made at IST. She would like to give a massive thank you to her teachers, friends, and family who put up with her in class throughout her IST journey.
Satwik Jalapali. Satwik is happy to make graduation. He will always cherish the relationships developed with his friends and teachers who are the reason he is standing before you today. He thanks his parents for being supportive on this journey, and most importantly, he looks forward to his Grammy. Shout out to Mr. Hewitt.
Sri Lakshmi Jayashankaran. Lakshmi has been at IST for 6 years and has had a wonderful experience. She is immensely grateful to her family, friends, and teachers for providing her with unforgettable memories.
Zuri Joseph DeGois. Zuri has been able to grow into her voice and keep it pushing. She will remember most fondly the days grade 12 was allowed to sleep in during extended homeroom. You're welcome.
Nakia Kadibai. Nakia would like to thank her family, friends, teachers, and everyone who supported her during these 2 years. She found the IBDP an enjoyable experience and looks forward to the opportunities presented when she attends university.
Hiro Kaka. Ready to toss that graduation cap, Hiro has survived the sleepless nights of the IB with her sanity mostly intact. She thanks her family, friends, and teachers. Through all the TikTok videos and planning extravagant Zanzibar trips, they have inspired her to pursue international business.
Tabelo Kaboko. Tabelo joined IST as a very shy person. Now she leaves IST a very confident, successful, and beautiful human being. She would really like to shout out to all her Upanga people and her best friends for always keeping her going. They are like family to her, for real.
George Kisena. George has made fond memories at IST and is grateful for the lifelong friends and relationships. A toast and a salute to those people, they know who they are. He sends his love to mom, dad, Jonathan, Simon, and his incredible sisters.
Simon Kasena. Simon has made the fondest memories at IST and is grateful for the lifelong friends and relationships. In his next chapter, he hopes to tackle the corporate world and get a Master of Science in Economics and Finance. Lastly, he sends his love to Mom, Dad, Jonathan, Simo, Simon, and his incredible sisters.
Ernego Kitoka. Ernego, a passionate learner and avid explorer, is thrilled to graduate after a year of endless possibilities and growth. As he moves on to the next chapter of life, he hopes to one day travel the world and work towards creating a more equitable and sustainable future for all.
Adrian Klates. Adrian has relished every moment of his year and a half at IST, except for maybe the biology IA. Adrian plans to further his studies and pursue a career in economic development. He extends his heartfelt gratitude to the warm and welcoming Twiga community for making his time at IST a truly unforgettable experience.
Vanara Kote Kankanamage. Vanara has enjoyed meeting new friends and getting to find out about herself at IST. She'll forever remember her friends and teachers who supported her through the tough times, and she wishes them all the best in the future.
Hannah Latterborn. After 5 years in Hong Kong, Hannah has made the most of her senior year at IST. She would like to give a special thank you to her family and friends for supporting her throughout her high school journey.
Iman Lalji. After 2,340 school days, minus a few sick ones and some she forgot to attend, Iman is finally walking across the stage. From Monday morning memo to beach days, MUN trips and more, she will never forget her time at IST.
Emily Lewis. Emily is so excited to graduate and is grateful for the people that have supported her through the IB program. She would like to thank her friends, family, and teachers for always being there for her.
Prashrad Megasparan. Prash has loved getting to know everyone here and making memories throughout the year. He wants to give a huge thank you to his parents, brothers, and friends for always being there for him, and to the new tech team in the back, the real MVPs here.
Kezia Merritt. Kezia, an aspiring filmmaker and artist, would like to thank her mom, Mavy, dad, Parnell, and her friends who have supported her as she conquered new challenges in IB. Kezia will never forget the beach days at Chico's and game nights at Logan's. 5 years from now, Kezia only wishes for happiness for everyone.
Sahana Mehta. Sahana is excited to graduate, but also sad to be leaving home and IST after 13 years. She's looking forward to studying health and medical sciences in the UK and wants to thank her parents, sisters, friends, dogs, and daily naps for helping her get through the IB.
And Zara Melman. After 6 years at IST, Anzara is thankful for all the support she's had from her teachers, family, and friends throughout the years. She's excited for a new adventure, but not excited for everyone new she meets to mispronounce her name again.
Jake Milicic. Jake would like to thank his supportive family and friends for the ebullience he has brought to his high school life. He is glad he has so many joyful memories. Thank you to all teachers in attendance. I really believe I was blessed to be in your classes. And love you, Mom.
Tumaini Mwakalinga. Tumaini would like to thank God, her whole family and friends, and her teachers, for they were always supported and there for her whenever she needed them. She wishes all the best for the next graduating class and her fellow graduates as you start a new chapter of your lives.
Jeffrey Mwandanji. Jeff will forever remember the friends, memories, and experiences made during his 3 years at IST. He would like to send a special shout out to Mr. Fosgreen and Mr. Steiner.
Songwoo Park. From China, Bulgaria, Korea, and Tanzania, Songwoo has persevered and matured, unhindered by the flood of IB examinations, turmoils of life, and other high school dramas. He has never faltered and is striving to become a better person. Now he walks to open a new chapter in his life with mandatory Korean military service. Bless his heart.
Isabel Powell. Izzy is looking forward to being one step closer to going to university and a lifetime of student loan debt. She especially would like to thank her parents and the one and only Alex.
Dibyanshi Pradhan. DB will remember most fondly all the people she's shown her light on and is looking forward to making money in the future. She is grateful for all her friends and fans and hopes to have left a mark on everyone's hearts. She hopes to be forever remembered as the funniest and coolest kid in this batch.
Kritika Rani. Gratitude, happiness, and thankfulness for all who have supported her, Krita makes her way across the stage, cherishing all the memories. Kritika's graduation from IST marks the beginning of her pursuit of medicine in India.
Isabel Reed. Isabel is grateful for the opportunities she's received at IST and would like to thank her friends, teachers, and the athletic department for making her experience memorable. She will miss Cocoa Beach and her family next year.
Charlotte Rodriguez.
Charlotte is incredibly happy to have returned to IST to graduate. She thanks her sisters, Penny and Addie, her father for relentlessly pushing her to do her work, and her incredible group of friends who she's so lucky to have.
Good to see you. Dia Shah. Dia expresses her gratitude to her loved ones and teachers for their support throughout her IB journey. With their encouragement, she now embarks on the pursuit of her passion in psychology.
Semoneko Sila. Sam would like to thank his friends, teachers, and the IST community in general for being a part of his amazing two-year journey at IST. He will always remember the fun times and beautiful memories made.
Anushka Soni. Anushka has been part of IST since second grade and has loved being part of this community. She'll forever remember Coach Hannah and her gym babies and can't wait to start a new chapter saying Alhamdulillah and being happy.
Graham Sterling. As the confetti falls and the crowd cheers, let me introduce the one and only Graham Sterling, a true embodiment of perseverance and dedication. He dreams of conquering the world with his infectious energy and innovative ideas.
Maureen Tangavelu. Maureen would like to extend a heartfelt thank you to her parents, friends, and siblings for their unwavering support throughout her academic journey. Maureen is planning to pursue a bachelor's degree in business and real estate.
Avril Valine. As Avril stands on the cusp of graduation, she is filled with a mixture of emotions, excitement, and gratitude as she reflects on the incredible journey that led her to this moment. Thank you, family, friends, and IST for the experiences that have contributed to shaping her into the person that she is today.
Bidzina Vetsko. Vivi's year had a couple of challenges, but nothing he'd change because he finally got here anyway. He hopes everyone is excited as he is to finish this part of life.
Ara Visaria. Ara will be attending the University of Illinois, Chicago, and is looking forward to learning how to cook. Ara will miss spending time with his family, going on rounds with friends, and especially miss paying brownie taxes to Mr. Fitz.
Lorenzo Vito. Lorenzo had a great time spending the last 2 years at IST. He is grateful to his friends and parents for the incredible memories and support they provided. Lorenzo is excited to begin his pilot training in Portugal and is looking forward to his new chapter in life.
Emily Whitbread. Emily is grateful for the lifelong friends she has made during her 3.5 years at IST and her parents who always encourage her to never give up. She will miss all of those incredibly kind and supportive teachers who have helped her through the IB program.
Daniel White. Daniel has been looking forward to graduating and really enjoyed his time at IST. He is very grateful for the support he got from his teachers and will miss his friends that stuck with him through high school.
Savely Yakovlev. Sav does not have any complaints about school. He plans to start a movement to liberate lefties from right-handed oppression.
Thank you.
Good evening. Could I please have my fellow classmates join me on stage? Distinguished guests, it is my pleasure to present to you the graduates of the class of 2023 of the International School of Tanganyika. Now, if the graduates could please join me in the ceremonial turn of our tassel to the left. As a representative of the class of 2023, and with the acknowledgement of IST's administration and board, I now pronounce us official graduates. Hongera sana.
Visions alone, Luther staring at me. Malcolm X put a hex on my future, someone catch me. I'm falling victim to a revolutionary song, the Serengeti's clone. Back to put you back, stab back on your spinal bone. Slit your disc when I slit you.